Direct from Cobo Center in Detroit, the Auto Channel presents complete video coverage of the 2007 North American International Auto Show.
Judges for the 2007 Michelin Challenge Design were Greg Brew, Director of Industrial Design, Lyris Industries, Patrick Lacamont, Senior Vice President of Corporate Design at Renault, Ruben Perfetti, Director of Design, Volvo Trucks, Frank Salcedo, Director, Advanced Design Studio, General Motors Corporation, Freeman Thomas, Director of Strategic Design at Ford, and Jeff Wardle, Associate Chair, Transportation Design, Arts Center College of Design. And our jury member and technical expert on vehicle safety was Dr. Anthony Stein, an advisor to the National Academy of Sciences and President and Technical Director of Safety Research Associates. At this time, it's my pleasure to introduce the chairman of our design jury, Stuart Reed, who's the chairman, Transportation Design, Arts Center College of Design, who will lead the designer walk around.
The first vehicle we'd like to look at here today is the Volvo 3cc safety car. This vehicle has brought together a number of different ideas and addresses things like seating configuration, ingress, egress, and overall safety. And here to tell us a bit more about the Volvo 3cc is Dr. Ichiro Sugioka of Volvo Car Corporation. Tell us a little bit about this concept.
Thank you, Stuart. In designing the Volvo 3C concept car, we had to try to make this small, lightweight vehicle as safe as a much bigger vehicle. Because the vehicle has much smaller comfort zone in the front, we had to devise a new way in which the seats, the two seats in the front and one in the back, slide forward in the frontal collision to cushion the occupants based on their body weight. The nice thing about that system is that we could also use a system in normal use to slide the seat forward so you could get into the back seat more easily. We also looked at the importance of side impact. The high belt line was designed to better meet the bumper structure on larger trucks. And we also put very thick doors on this very narrow vehicle. And that was accomplished by putting the lithium-ion batteries under the floor instead of in the tunnel, so that we could still have room for the wide, comfortable seats that you see here. Anyway, I could keep going talking more about this car, but I know there's a lot of other interesting designs out there that I personally would like to hear about. So, Stuart, maybe it's time to move on to the other designs.
Yeah, thanks, Ash, very much.
Next, we would like to make our way over to a very interesting Honda Civic Ace body structure. This Honda Civic Ace body structure is the result of Honda's testing and analysis in the dynamics of collisions. Honda developed the advanced compatibility engineering of this Ace body structure. It helps to spread the energy of a frontal collision throughout the vehicle's entire body structure. Honda looked at a number of key questions in doing this project, like how to reduce initial impact at the front end. The importance of pedestrian safety is also a big consideration in front impact design. This is, of course, used in the Honda Civic now, and they expect to have this appear on other models as well. So we very much appreciate Honda for their continued support in bringing this exhibit. When Michelin's Challenge Design was created, one of the goals was to bring forward designs from all over the world, not only from car companies and design houses, but also from independent designers and even students. Today we have the first concept car ever designed for Michelin Challenge Design, and I'm pleased to introduce to you Uroš Pavasovic, a young designer from Slovenia, and his designs have actually impressed our jurors in previous years with two-dimensional work, and today we are pleased to welcome Uroš back to the North American International Auto Show, and he presents really the world premiere and first ever full-size concept car by Uroš. So, it's very exciting. Tell us a little bit about your concept.
Thank you very much. I hope you can hear me. The first goal when designing this car was to show that even a very small car can be safe, and look cool. I'll just show a few features, not to be too long. First thing is that the body is a thick wraparound protective body, and on top of this body we have large, lightweight glass dome, so we have a, we create a sociable character for a car and not an armored vehicle. The second thing is the very high, well, quite high leading edge, which has two advantages. One is in a collision with a taller vehicle. They are, well, I think they're quite unusual, and also they can illuminate the corners when the car is turning. So another safety feature.
Roche, tell us about your name, Scratch. Why the name Scratch on this concept?
Scratch, that's the cool factor of the car. These scratches are inspired by the torn jeans. Torn jeans look, you know, the cooler, the more torn they are. So this car should look, you know, the more you use it, the cooler it is.
Thank you
very much.
Thank you. As designers and manufacturers and drivers, sharing the road means having to occupy the roadways with millions of vehicles of varying sizes. Ruben Parfetti is Director of Design for Volvo Trucks and a member this year of our design jury. Ruben, cars and trucks, especially trucks coming out of your studios, have very different shapes and size needs. Tell us what sharing the road means to Volvo design for trucks.
Thank you, Stuart, and thank you, Michelin, for having us here at the North American International Auto Show, allowing Volvo Trucks North America to display one of our models. Sharing the road for us as truck designers and truck drivers is always on our mind. When we designed the B-Van here, we took into consideration where the driver would be and how this vehicle would occupy the road. The designer, Paul Daintree, positioned the truck driver front and center, wrapped glass all the way around him, so that the driver would have nearly 180 degrees of visibility forward, and then with a few cameras, we could eliminate all the blind spots. Combine this sleek aerodynamic design with the next generation of leading technology, like vehicle proximity detection, lane tracking devices, and driver drowsiness detection. It really gives the vehicle a very safe operation to share the road with other vehicles.
We were talking yesterday about aerodynamics along the side and influencing the adjoining lanes. You
right.
Want to comment on that?
Paul, when he looked at the design, he also took into consideration ingress and egress. So the door opens, slides rearwards, the steps come out of the vehicle, creating sort of a greeting the driver. Once the driver is inboard with all his gear, the door closes, the steps retract and create a very clean and sleek aerodynamic design that is also reduces the turbulence along the side of the vehicle.
And talking about that yesterday, it's interesting that Michelin has here on the stand, I'd point out to my left, the XZA2 anti-splash truck tire. And it again draws attention to the safety of large vehicles and protecting the vehicle in the adjoining lane. So I think that's most interesting. Thank you, Ruben. Okay, next we have the Revolver concept car. Polaris Industries includes Polaris ATVs, snowmobiles, Ranger work vehicles, and of course, Victory motorcycles. Matt Tandrup is the designer behind the Revolver ATV concept here. And Matt, how did you make a four-wheeler that was originally designed for off-road use to be safe for road use?
First off, Stuart, I'd just like to thank Michelin for inviting us to come to the show and bring an ATV to a car show. So I think that's a pretty unique thing and a first probably for Detroit. The Revolver concept we're very excited about. It was originally designed for the European market. In Europe right now, off-road ATVs are homologated or changed to and then sold for on-road use. This ATV was designed specifically for on-road use, and some of the features that make it safe and more stable, the vehicle has been lowered 50%, the swing arm has been stretched out 3 inches, and the stance has been dramatically widened. And what that gets you is that it gets the rider and the vehicle a lower CG to the ground, which makes it more stable for on-road use. Some of the other things that you'll notice is that we also have large automotive tires. They're also low profile, so it's better for handling and traction. We also have some Nerf bars around the sides here that protects the occupant's legs and feet from side impacts and as well as also debris coming up off of the road. How we've made it higher visibility on the road is that we've applied automotive lights and signals all the way around the vehicle, which is unique and different for an ATV. So those are some of the things the Revolver concept has done to address safety on the road.
Great. Thank you very much, Matt. At this time, I'd like to turn the program back to Tom Chubb.
And thank you so much to all the designers. I'd like to just elicit a little round of applause now to your mind for the designers who participated in this event. In addition to the designers that you just met, there's another group of very talented designers whom I'd like to recognize right now. And these are the designers whose works were selected by the jury and are displayed here today. In fact, they're a very interesting group, and if you just listen to where they're from, you'll note that the importance now of design on a global level. It's amazing. Let's have them introduce themselves.
Your name and country, please.
Nicolás Cerruti, de Argentina.
I'm Marian Miranda, I'm from Argentina. Thank you. Name and country, please.
Alberto Cruz from Mexico.
Edgar Sandria from Mexico.
Carlos Reno from Mexico.
Hector Regalado from Mexico.
Andre Sims, USA.
Andrew Park from South Korea.
Leonardo Lopez Movilla, originally from Peru, by the United States.
I'm Evan Brooks from Canada.
And can you also say your age for us?
I'm 14 years old.
Thank you very much.
Each of these designers or design teams, as the case may be, has their own story, and they will be stationed during their work, so if you're interested in finding out more, by all means, please feel free to approach them and ask them questions. Now, it's my pleasure to introduce John Grimaldi. John is the president of Michelin's worldwide original equipment business for passenger and light truck, and he's got a very important announcement for us for next year's Michelin Challenge Design. John?
Thank you, Tom. So at this time, it's our tradition to announce the theme for next year's Michelin Challenge Design. And for 2008, we have chosen to continue our focus on safety while addressing an area that is extremely timely as the world of transportation faces new challenges in higher energy costs, environmental concerns, and traffic congestion. The Michelin Challenge Design in January 2008 at the North American International Auto Show will display vehicles and vehicle concepts which with attributes that make safety independent of vehicle size. Next year's theme will be safety over size. Rising energy costs, urban congestion, and environmental concerns are all contributing to increased interest in smaller cars. But consumers are often hesitant to consider small vehicles due to safety concerns that are both real and perceived. Now, part of the challenge for the designers will be to recognize those concerns and through design concepts provide both real and perceived enhancements and a greater feeling of security in smaller vehicles. Designers will be encouraged to throw away the book and to present ideas that enhance safety through design innovation in areas such as accident avoidance, enhanced driver controls, survivability, and visibility. We hope you will agree that next year's Michelin Challenge Design will bring us all a bit closer to finding a better way forward. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to thank you for being here with us today. We'd like now to invite the media and our guests to please enjoy all the work presented here and meet all the outstanding designers. Thank you very much.
Thanks for watching the Auto Channel. For more automotive fun and information, visit theautochannel.com, the Internet's most complete and comprehensive automotive information resource.